struggling to get motivated, Hollywood star Shia LaBeouf has this advice.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Just do it!
I liked him better when he had the paper bag on his head. Our next guest says we need less of that and more of the Angry Birds game to really get us motivated. Let's find out more from psychologist Gavin Freeman. Gavin, welcome to the show.
Just do it.
Hey, Nike's made an absolute moxer from that very tagline, just do it. What's wrong with that?
Well, there's nothing wrong with it. You know, the just do it kind of works. But I think what we need to realise is what's sitting behind the why we're not doing it. You know, and I don't want to tap back into the conversation you guys had a little bit before. But, you know, think about why we don't do stuff. And motivation is really the driver. It's what really gets us going. And every one of us is different. So Shia getting up there and kind of going the just do it might work for some people, but it probably won't work for everybody. We really need to find out what's really driving us. But we also need to look at how we respond to failure. And that's the important piece.
And how does Angry Birds get involved in all this?
Well, think about the game. It's a great game, you know, particularly if you want to procrastinate just a little bit. But the whole game's driven behind trying, failing, learning from your process. You go over and over again. You look at the diversity of the birds, so you see different approaches. Every bird does something slightly different to achieve your goal. But what it also does is it means once you've achieved your goal, you get one star or two stars in the game, you're still driving to get or striving to get that third star, to do better at it. So it's sort of, I love it in the fact that it gives you both an end goal, so you can work towards getting the three stars, but it also says to you, it's okay to fail. Let's learn from our failure. Let's not hide away from it.
So aren't you failing to do what you're meant to be doing because you're too busy playing Angry Birds?
Well, look, you know, maybe do it in your spare time as a way of just practicing and understanding your inner drivers and how you respond and learn. Maybe not do it at work when the boss is watching.
Because I like what you say about failure, that it's their stepping stones to success. And that's a good good way to think about it. One thing, though, that I do take issue with your approach is that you say if you think something, that doesn't mean it's going to happen. Like, I'm a big believer in if you think something and you really think hard about it and then visualise it and then start to talk about it, it's the first step towards making something happen.
Oh, absolutely. I know, I'm not saying you shouldn't think about it. Clearly, positive affirmations absolutely work and having that focus point and having a goal. What we need to be conscious of is not to have too many outcome goals, so it's just the end goal. So if we reflect back on maybe the Olympics that have just happened, let's not think about winning the gold medal. Let's think about all the steps we need to take to achieve that, so that we're able to achieve things, we don't always focus on just the outcome, because that's sometimes where it falls a little short. If we look like we're not going to get that outcome, then sometimes we give up just a little too early.
It's interesting to have a look at what actually motivates us. Some of us are motivated to succeed, but others are motivated not to fail.
Yeah, there's this continuum that I've looked at, and really it moves from motivated to succeed through to motivated to avoid failure. And unfortunately, there's a lot of examples around where we see people who are motivated to avoid failure, and we see some of the behaviours that they start to demonstrate. You know, and we often see it in the public's eye. The challenge we find is that when we're watching somebody, it's very difficult to tell which side of the continuum they're on. It's just when they start to fail, that's where we see things going pear-shaped.
Give us an example.
Well, you know, the classic in my mind is think of Lance Armstrong. You know, he was an incredible athlete. He won 7 Tour de France. He was doing fantastically well. And then all of a sudden, later on, we find out all the cheating that he did to ensure that failure. He was so focused on not being negatively evaluated by himself or by others that he ended up having to cheat to achieve his goals.
So if you figure out what type of person you are, whether you're motivated by wanting to succeed or to avoid failure, then what should you do?
Well, there's a couple of things. Understand where you are on the continuum, but this is the important piece. Everybody can move on the continuum. So some of us, when we're motivated to avoid failure, it's simply based on the context that we're in. And if we're able to change that environment, so for the workplace, it's often around, you know, how do we enable people to learn in our environment? If you're dealing with your kids, it's helping them to understand the impacts of what they're doing. You know, My kids are actually here in the studio with me, and we had a conversation on the way in, and they were talking about, you know, how well they're going to do in particular sports. And their focus is around what they need to do and what they're getting better at, not whether they win or lose. So it's focusing on the steps rather than necessarily focusing on the outcome as a starting point. Also understanding what's your inner thought when you become motivated to avoid failure. And that's where we can catch ourselves in the real time and say, no, I'm not going to get focused on the failure component, I'm going to focus on the learning component.
Gavin's book is called Just Stop Motivating Me, and it's available from his website, gavinfreeman.com.au. Gavin, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure, guys. Stop motivating people today.